Hey everybody, it's Tox from Crits Happen. Thanks for watching and welcome back. Today, we are going to play a game. Yes, you and I are going to play a game, and it's really, really fun. It's a game called Tiny Towns from AEG, Alderac Entertainment Group. This is a really unique game, and for me, unique is very hard to find in the world of board gaming, so that's why I'm really excited about this. The other thing that I'm really keen on is the way we're going to play this game actually allows us to play right now, or play a year from now, or come back and play 10 years from now. We're going to be playing in a mode called Town Hall. That's going to basically mean that I am going to use these resource cards to call out resources, and we'll be able to use them as I go through the deck. That means that you can watch this video with your own copy of Tiny Towns, using the same buildings that we're going to use today, and play along and challenge your score versus my score to see how we all work out. Now, I pretty much will say I'll probably lose, because the very first time I played this game, I got 0 points. Yes, 0 total points. This is a game that the first time you see it, you're like, oh, this is so easy. I'm just going to put resources on this board and I'm going to make buildings. And then you start to realize really quickly, it's not that easy. There is a ton, absolute metric ton of strategy inside this game. The other thing to note is that while we're going to be using the 7 buildings I'll show you in a moment, the buildings are different every time you play the game. There's 4 different types of building for each building type, meaning that for each sculpt of building, you're going to have multiple different options every time you play. It's a really, really fun game, and I'm really looking forward to this. So, join me here. We'll go through the 7 buildings that we're about to look at and use, and you too can challenge me to a game of Tiny Towns. So let's begin by taking a look at the 7 buildings that we're going to use for this game. To set up, you're going to want to use the granary, the cottage, the shed, the theater, the temple, the inn, and the trading post. One more time, the granary, the cottage, the shed, the theater, the temple, the inn, and the trading post. Now again, every time you play Tiny Towns, this is going to be different, except for one thing, which is the cottage. The cottage is always static and always part of every game. But every other building and its design is going to be different each time. Let's take a closer look at what each card does. The granary says, feeds all buildings of a specific type, which is the cottage essentially in this game, in the 8 squares surrounding the granary. The cottage says that it will be worth 3 points if the building is fed. The shed is 1 point and may be constructed on any empty square in your town. The theater is 1 point for each other unique building type in the same row and column as the theater. The temple is 4 points if it is adjacent to 2 or more fed cottages, so you can already see some synergies happening. The inn is 3 points if not in a row or a column with another inn, because if you're an innkeeper, you don't want competition. And one of my favorite cards in the game is the trading post. It's worth 1 point on its own. It takes 5 resources to build, which is pretty big. And it says you may treat the trading post as a wild resource for future buildings. Now, in addition to this, I am going to play with a monument. I've shuffled up and I dealt out my monument, and I'm going to take a look at it now for the first time. I would highly suggest you do the same. However, I would suggest if you get the same card I'm about to flip over that you don't use that, since there's only 1 copy of each of these cards in the game, and therefore it might actually change up what we would do. Let's take a look at which monument that I got. I got the Cathedral of Katarina. This is going to require a stone, a glass, and a wheat. It says it is 2 points. Empty squares in your town are worth 0 instead of -1. That's going to be a huge advantage. So, yeah, that'll be really fun. So let's take a look at what it means to actually build these buildings and how you build these buildings with the resources at hand. So we've talked a little bit about the buildings we're going to use. Let's now talk about how we actually build these buildings in our town. As the game is going to progress, we're going to be taking these resource cards, shuffling them up, and using them to call out resources. The way the rounds are going to work is round 1, I will bring out a card and I will call out that card, in this case stone, and we would all take a stone and put that onto our board on one of the places. You must put the resource that's called. You do not have an option. You have to do that. The next card will come out, and let's say, for example, here we have glass. So glass can go anywhere again on your board. And let's say I will put this right here. What you're trying to do is you're trying to build the patterns of the buildings that are available to you in the game. Now, in the town hall mode, we're going to roll over one card for round one, one card for round two. Now on round three, we will each get to pick our own resource. So, for example, if you wanted to pick wood, you could do that. If I wanted to pick wheat, I could do that. Now, you'll notice that this is very similar to this. This cathedral requires me to have stone, glass, and wheat. I have stone, glass, and wheat. It does not need to be like this exactly, matching up the card. You can have it in a different orientation as long as the resources connected to each other are connected in the correct way. This would allow me to build my monument. And what does it mean to build a monument? It means that I take the matching meeple of the building. So the monument is up here on the right. It shows me that this is my monument. Monuments are unique in that you're only able to build one per game, and it's only you that can build that monument. The other players cannot build your monument. But I get to place this on any one of these three spaces, and then I would remove the resources on the board, freeing up the remaining spaces. We're going to continue to do that until neither one of us are able to continue to place cubes or buildings on our space. You must fill up all of the spaces on your board as you are playing. So what that means is that if you are unable to build a building with the resources you place, you must still place them on there. Now, normally, at the end of the game, each empty square that does not have a building in it is going to cost you -1, meaning that if I end the game and there is a glass here and I haven't been able to build a building there, that's going to be worth -1. If I'm able to build my cathedral, though, that's going to negate that and it's going to go to 0, which could definitely help for scoring at the end of the game. For now, though, you can go ahead and get out your 7 buildings that we just talked about, shuffle up and deal yourself a monument, and let's sit down and play a town hall game of Tiny Towns. Alrighty, we are ready to play Tiny Towns. I am actually really looking forward to this, and we'll see how it works out. I have played several games of this and never had the same game twice, which is really cool. So just as a reminder, I have to get my monument off my board. That's cheating at the beginning. Just as a reminder, the games, the cards that we're playing with for the buildings are the granary, the cottage, the shed, the theater, the temple, the inn, and the trading post. So let's take a look and kind of remind ourselves about what these do. The granary is going to feed my cottages, and if the cottages are fed, they're worth 3 points. The only way this is going to work, though, is if we have a granary and then the cottages are in the 8 squares around them. If a cottage is down here, that's not going to work. So we got to be mindful of that as we play the game. And this is going to go for you as well because you're playing along with me. The shed is really, really resourceful because the shed allows you to get 1 point and it can be constructed anywhere on an empty square in your town. What that means, which is really kind of fun, let's say throughout the game, you have a theater here and you have an inn here and you've blocked yourself out of that square. If you're able to configure a shed, which is a brown, a wood, and a gray, which is a stone, you can then take them off, and instead of having to build your building on one of these two, you could build the building there. So the shed gives you a little more flexibility, which is really, really nice, especially in very, very tight situations. The theater is 1 point for each other unique building type in the same row or column. So what that means is if I have a theater, if I have a temple, if I have an inn, and if I have a trading post in this row, that is going to be 1 point for each other unique building type. So that'll be 1, 2, 3 points for that temple, which is really, really cool. It also counts the columns as well. So if I was able to have this granary, this cottage, and this shed built here, which is really tough, but if it's possible, this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points for this theater because there's 6 unique buildings there. It would be pretty challenging, and I'd love to challenge myself to do that, but I'd also like to win our little game here, so we'll see how that works out. The temple is 4 points if it is adjacent to 2 or more fed cottages. And remember, the only way you can feed cottages is by being around the 8 boxes of a granary itself. The inn is very thematic. It says it's 3 points, and if not in a row with an, it is 3 points if not in a row or column with another inn. What that means is if I have this and this, all of these inns are worth nothing because they are in the same row or same column as another inn. But if I had this, That would be worth a lot of points. That's 9 points right there. The basic idea of that is if you're an innkeeper, you don't want to look down the road and see another inn. You want to have complete control over your area. The final one, the trading post, is very, very challenging to build because it takes the most resources out of any of the pieces. It takes 5 resources. But it says that it's worth 1 point and you may treat the trading post as a wild resource. What that means is, let's say I'm able to build a trading post here, and then later in the game, I am able to take a stone and a wheat right here. I can use this as a glass, a stone, and a wheat in this configuration to then make an inn and place it on one of these 2 spaces. So the trading post is highly, highly versatile and really, really is like helpful in the game. But again, it is very, very challenging because it is going to be 5 different resources to build. As a reminder, I am using the Cathedral of Katarina, which is 2 points if I build it, and it makes all of my empty squares, meaning building spaces without buildings at the end of the game, are going to be worth 0 instead of -1 point. So I don't know what your monument is, but I hope it's good and I hope it's different because there's only 1 of these in each game, so you don't want to have 2 of them in play. So let's shuffle these resource cards, let's get right into it, and let's start playing Tiny Towns. All right, now I will be very honest with everyone. The first game I played of this game, I did not do very well. I won't say my score, but I'll say it wasn't very high. But after that, I learned how to get into things. All right, so let's take a look at what our first card is, and you, again, will play along with me. Our first option is wood. Okay, I am going to take my wood, you will take your wood, and we will put it onto our board together. There is a specific strategy that I really like with the trading post, so I am going to go for that. Round 2, our next card is also wood. So we'll take another wood, we'll give you a second or two to get your wood and decide where you want to place it. I am going to place mine right here. So we have 2 wood for the starting 2 rounds. The 3rd round, we get to choose our own resource. So, you know what? All right, so let's get started here. The first thing we do is we shuffle up the cards that are the resource cards, and we're gonna deal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 off to the side. We're then going to start calling out resources, and you and I will both use these resources to play our game. The very first resource is wheat. All right, well, there's only 3 buildings that use wheat, and I have the opportunity of using my cathedral for wheat. I will take my wheat, and you shall take your wheat, and we will put them onto our board anywhere we want. Are you good to go? I hope so. I'm going to try and give you enough time in between rounds to place where you would like to place, but the nice thing and the beauty about the interwebs is you can pause this video whenever you'd like to catch up. Our next resource is wood. All right, we'll take a wood. I think we're building towards possibly a granary maybe, or maybe a little more. I'm actually going to be a little flexible here, and I'm going to put my wood right there. All right, now it's round 3. So after you have placed your wheat and your wood, we're going to be able to pick our own resource of any type we like. I think I am going to pick another wood as my resource. So I'm going to pick a brick. I'll pick a brick as my resource, and I will put that brick right here. Yes, okay. Let's move on to round 4. Round 4 is another wheat. Well, that works out very nicely for me. I don't know if you've done the same thing, but I've gone ahead and built a granary, so I will take a granary and put it onto my board. I am going to put it right here, which may be a little challenging from a perspective of building a trading post in the future, but we'll see how that goes. I hope you were able to build a granary too, or maybe I don't. Maybe that means you're going to get points that I don't want to get or that you may end up beating me with. So we'll have to see how it works out. But for now, I built a granary and we'll move on to the next round. The next round is a wood. So we're going to get another wood. This means we have 2 wood and 2 wheat already used from here, which is very interesting. I will put my wood right here. I think I would really like to get a trading post, but I think that's going to be really tricky. So we have done 2, and we are now onto a 3rd round again, so we're going to be able to build our own, take our own resource. So let's go ahead and pick our own resource. You can pick whatever you would like. I am going to pick a stone. Put a stone right there. Yeah, I think that's good. Okay. Have you picked your resource? I hope so. Let's go on to the next round. The next round is stone. So we have stone. I will take another stone and I will put that right there in the hopes that this is going to lead to a trading post. The key thing is we don't know what these five cards are, so those could be the other stones I need or the other wooden brick that I need. For our next round, we will do a brick. Okay, that works out very nice. I'm going to take a brick and put a brick right here. All I need is one more wood. Problem is that we know that we have two wood gone already of the three wood. Well, the good thing is now we're back to choosing our own resource. So this is the third round. So once every three rounds, I guess is the right way to say it. So we get to choose our own resource. So I will go ahead and choose wood. I'll let you go ahead and choose your resource as well. And in the meantime, I'm going to build a trading post. How I'm going to build that trading post is going to be interesting, though. I think I'm going to put my trading post right there, which may or may not be the best decision in the world, but since it does count as a wild, hopefully it will do very well. It does take away from a space that I could put a cottage, but I highly doubt that I would get eight cottages around that one granary. All right, let's move on to the next two rounds. Selecting resources, we have a glass. All righty, I think we'll put a glass right there. Glass is only used in four instances in this setup. One, two, three, four. The most common looks to be wood. One, two, three, four, five, six wood. And one, two, three, four, five brick. So wood and brick, and then it looks like stone, wheat, and then glass. So let's see what comes up next. Our next is also a glass. Okay. Well, now, what do we do with that? I think we'll put that right here. Yes, I think we'll put that right there. Okay, so next up is going to be the option to select your own resource. So I am going to select brick, I think, possibly. Yes, I think I'm going to select brick. I'm going to put brick, and I'm going to put brick there. This gives me brick, glass, and I will use my trading post as a wild for wheat. And I will get a cottage, and I will put a cottage right here. So I almost took that glass off. That would be cheating and illegal, so that's not good. All right, so that cottage is fed. So right now, if you're keeping tabs, I have a total of 4 points, plus a whole lot of negatives, because negatives right now, because I haven't built my cathedral. All righty, let us now take the last two cards and go to the last three rounds, and we will choose a brick. Okay, so that works out great for me. I am going to put a brick right here. With a brick, with a glass, and with a wheat again as a wild trading post, I will make a cottage, and I will put my cottage right here, which is both good because I'm getting things fed and getting points, but I'm also starting to eat up the spaces around which I can use my trading post as a wild. The last selectable resource here is also brick, so we will get another brick out here. I have to think about this now. How am I going to want that to work out? It's going to be very challenging to put a cottage up here, but it could work. I may want to go towards the temple possibly up there. I think that might be a good opportunity. So if that's the case, I'm going to put a brick right there. Then as our final round, we're going to be able to select any resource we want. I am also going to select another brick, and I am going to put that brick right there. Now, as you can see, we're out of cards. So what do we do? Game's over. No, the game is not over. We're going to take all of our cards, we're going to shuffle them back up, and we're going to have a new round with five cards put off to the side again. I should think about building my cathedral, because that would be very, very beneficial to me. But I'm going to have to find the right opportunity for that cathedral to get into there. So, all right, so one, two, three, four, five, and we're off and running again. Again, if you're having any trouble keeping up, feel free to pause the video at any time. You can catch up and jump back in that way. Brick! Isn't that nice? I have an overabundance of brick in my area here. what do I want to do with this? I don't want to build cottages over here. I want to build temples. Trading posts would be pretty difficult to do. You know what? I'm going to put my brick right there. All right. Then as our second resource, oh, another brick. This is getting a little crazy. This is a run on brick, folks. This is pretty wild. Well, what can we do here? Another brick in the wall. I think we're going to have to get a little creative on this. Won't be able to build a trading post out of there. I won't be able to do anything. There's really the only thing with two bricks next to it is the temple. I guess I'm going to have to put a brick right there. So we'll have to maybe build towards the temple down here. So we've taken two cards. We now get to select our own resource. So let's go ahead and do that. I am going to go ahead and build with a stone and put a stone right here. You can select whatever you'd like. I now have a, what do I have here? I have red, stone, and glass. So I could build a temple if I wanted to. I may actually hold off on that. One of the interesting things about the game is you do not have to build immediately when you have a building built. You can kind of combination up with some different things. I think that might be the right thing for me to do right now. It might be a little risky, but we'll see how it works out. All right, our next card is a stone. Okay, so now perhaps I do want to do that. I think I will. So I will go ahead with two red, a gray, and a blue. I will build my temple. That's going to go right here. And then, that has to be next to two fed cottages. And if I go there, that's not adjacent. Boy, that's going to be pretty darn silly tough, actually, if I do that. That's going to be really tough. In fact, I don't think I would be able to do it, which would be bad. That would be really bad. That's really bad. I don't want to do that. I'm not going to do that. So I'm going to put back out my resources that I had. And I have my stone I have to place from this. Well, this is going to get really tricky now. This is what happens in this game. You think everything's fine. You're like, hey, I built a trading post. It's all good. I got all these things to do. And then suddenly you've boxed yourself in. Or in my case, boxed myself out, I guess is the better way to say. I have to place this stone. Where do I want to place this stone? This stone is going to be tricky. It may be the bane of my existence. I am going to place this stone. I'm going to place this stone right here. I have an idea. I should have thought about this before. So we have one more card before we select our own card, our own resource. So wood. We have wood. That's good. That's really good. All right. So I'm going to take a wood and put a wood right there. You can take a wood and put a wood on your tableau or your little forest woodland creature area as well in your tiny town. And I think I may have like dodged the bullet here and gotten out of something, which would actually be really, really helpful and really, really nice. So now we get to select our own resource. I am going to select a brick, and with two stone, two wood, and a brick, I will build a trading post. Now the question is, where do I want to build this trading post? Because this is going to get really, really tricky. If I build a trading post here, that would definitely still help me build a temple. I could build a cottage then there too, which would give me a cottage there, but I wouldn't be able to feed it. Challenging. I could put it up here, but having them diagonal to each other may not be beneficial. The choices, the decisions, what am I going to do? You know what? Just go for it. I'm going to put it right here. So stone, stone, wood, wood, and brick builds me a destroyed cottage. It builds me my second trading post, which could be beneficial. I can also pull a combo if I wanted, because I have a brick. I now have a glass and I have a wheat to be able to put a cottage here if I wanted to. But if I put a cottage here, that's two cottages. They're not connected to each other. Or they're not going to be fed because this guy only feeds around this area right here. All that brick. Man, all that brick. The other option I could do, maybe it would be better to leave that brick there for right now. The only thing it requires this is the temple. And putting the temple there really hurts me. I don't think of how I'm going to get a cottage over there. So I think I might actually be humped in this corner, which would be pretty bad. Okay, let's get back to it. Let's take our next card. Our next card is a wheat. A wheat is great. I'm going to put a wheat right here. and I now have a wheat, a glass, and a stone, which is my cathedral. I'm going to remove my wheat, and I'm going to put a cathedral right here. So at the very least, I don't have negative points now, which is a big help. Yeah, let's go with that. All right, next card. Next card up is glass. Glass. Glass, glass, glass. What can I do with glass? There's not much that I can do with glass, actually, that will be beneficial to me. So, I'm going to put a glass right there. Yeah, I think I should put a glass right there. That is our second card, so we get to choose our own resource right now. I will choose a wheat. You can choose whatever you would like. With my wheat, glass, and brick, I will make a cottage in one of these upper areas right around here. Now I can go here, here, or here. If I go here, I can somehow get the temple there, which I don't think is gonna happen. There's just no way to do that. If I go there, that might be better. Go there, that might be better. I think if I go there, I'm hurting myself there. I think I will go right here. Have I mentioned I'm not a city planner and that I'm terrible at city planning games, but I do love them so. Yeah, okay. All right, so our next two cards, let's see what we get. Our next card is wood. So, wood. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck? This is gonna start getting tough, kids. This is gonna start getting tough. I'm gonna put a... Yeah, there's no way I'm gonna be able to do that. Huh. Man, this is gonna get tough, guys. All right, so I'm really glad I got Cathedral because I may not get a lot of points here. I think I'm going to have to put a wood right here. Our next card is a stone. Hey, look at that. That's exactly what I wanted. I'm going to put a stone right here. Now, that does allow me to build a shed. I'm not going to build it just yet, though, so we'll wait and see how that works out. Right now, I get to pick whatever resource I want to pick, and I think let's take a look at what we had in the past here. We had one, we only had one glass, so I think glass may come out. I am going to choose wheat, and I'm going to put wheat right here. I'm banking on the granary and cottage strategy right now, and my cathedral from helping me. I hope that you've enjoyed picking your resource, because we're on to our last two cards. The next one is a wood. I don't like that at all. I do not like that, Sam I am. I do not like it at all. I'm gonna have to put that right here. I'm running out of options. I'm running out of space. Let's see what our next one is. Our next one is a wheat. Ah, I picked wrong. I was hoping that we would get a glass, but apparently there's glass in here. A wheat. A wheat. I don't think this is gonna work very well at all. Where am I gonna put that wheat? You know what? I'm gonna have to put the wheat right here for right now. Then we get to choose our own resource. I will go ahead and choose a glass and put that here. That allows me to do a brick, a glass, and a wheat. Therefore, I will build a cottage, and I will build a cottage right here. And here's where, if I had thought a little better, I could have built these two to build a shed here and use a shed in that space rather than leaving the wheat there. But that's okay. I will, however, probably build a couple of more sheds right now. So the first thing I will do is I will use these two to build a shed, and I will build a shed here, and then I will use a gray and a stone from the wilds to build a shed right here. Yeah, I think that's it. So let's go ahead and shuffle up the cards, and this will more than likely be the final round of our Town Hall game of Tiny Towns. Let's see how it all works out, which I think at this point is going to be a lot of cottage points and not much else, but we'll see how it works. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, here we go, kids. Stone. Stone it is. Stone. Stone there would not do anything for me. Not do anything. That temple granary cottage combination is really hard to pull off. And as I say that, you probably have pulled it off very well. Stone. I'll take a gamble. We'll put it there. I have concerns about that, but we'll take a look at that. Our next one is wheat. Yeah, that didn't work out. Okay, so before I do anything, I'm going to pick these two up. I'll build a temple here, which gives me stone or brick, stone, glass. I'll build a temple there. It's not really going to do anything for me. But I will actually put the wheat right there. And then I will, with our selection, choose a glass. You get to choose as well. I'll pick a glass. That's actually going to build me an inn. So I will take these three off, a wheat, a stone, and glass, and put an inn. And I will put an inn right up there. All right. Now we go back to selection of cards. This is getting very, very tight. Brick. Of course, the one resource that really won't help me at all right now. It's not going to matter, and I may or may not be able to get anything over there, but let's see what we can do with this. I'm going to put a brick right there. It's not going to be worth anything at the end of the game. We'll see how it goes. The next card is a stone. Okay, that's good. With a stone, I can put a stone right here, and more importantly, I can stone and wood, and I can create a shed using my trading post, and I will put a shed right there. That means that we now get to choose our own resource. So I will go ahead and choose a wood. You two can choose a resource. And with my wood and my stone, I will pull this up and I will put a shed here. Now, I am done. There's nothing else that I can do with my stuff. Yes, while these do make a shed, I can't pull one off. While this acts as a wild resource, it does not count as anything else. Now, the game could continue because you could not be done with yours. So just to be sure, we'll go ahead and roll out a couple of more cards. The next resource you should take is wood. So if you're still playing along at home, go ahead and take a wood, put that onto your board. Perhaps maybe you've been able to construct a theater, which I apparently don't care about the arts at all because I did not do that. I was more focused on housing, my cathedral, and trading posts. So this is much more of a mercantile town. The next one that you would take would be glass. So go ahead and take a glass now and place that into your area. And I don't know, depending on what your monument is, there are so many different monuments in the game, and I mean so many. These are just the monuments. There's so many different options in the game that you can choose from and shuffle and deal out randomly. Now that you've taken a wood and a glass, you can take your own selection. So select any one of the five resources: wheat, stone, wood, glass, or brick. I'd highly suggest against brick because we seem to have drawn a lot of bricks this game, but that's okay. And hopefully, again, if this is not enough time for you to select your resources and place them, you can always pause the video and pick up again. All right, so we have two new cards. The next card, and I'm just going to go through this deck. Stone will be the next card, so go ahead and place a stone onto your tableau. If you're still playing, you're probably going to crush me in score, which is awesome and super cool because that's a good thing. The next one is going to be a wood. So you'll go ahead and place a wood anywhere on your board. And then after you place your wood, you'll be able to pick any resource that you want. So you can go ahead and pick any resource that you would like. Add that to your board. Continue to make more buildings and get more points, which is all really good. And then I'll go ahead and roll through these final two cards as well, which would be wheat. So go ahead and place a wheat on your board. Don't place it like mine, where it's out in the middle of nowhere. I guess thematically it works, right? There's a granary and there's wheat next to the granary, but they weren't able to utilize that wheat, so it probably died in the winter. So, and then the final one is brick. Brick, go ahead and place that onto your board wherever you would like. And then after you place your brick, go ahead and place any resource of your choice. Now, if by chance you are still playing and you still have moves to make, feel free to take your own resource cards, because you should have a copy of Tiny Towns if you're playing along. Shuffle them up, go ahead and deal five off to the side, and then continue playing until you're out of places to place resources and or buildings. And then let's tally up our final scores. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and tally up my score here with you, with me. So Tox, what did Tox get? Tox, for trading posts, has two trading posts, which means they are worth 2 points. Cottages are 3 points if they are fed, and they are fed if they are around the 8 boxes of the granary. In my case, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 fed cottages, so that'll be worth 12 points. Temples. Sadly, my temple is abandoned. My church has been forsaken. This is 4 points if adjacent to 2 or more fed cottages, and I am only adjacent to 1. Therefore, I get a big fat goose egg for my temple. Then we look at inns. Inns are 3 points if not in the same row or column with another inn. Well, that's really good for me because I didn't build any more inns. So with the inn, I will get 3 points. The theater is next, and as you can tell, my city does not care for the arts as we discussed, so I will get 0 points for the theaters. The sheds, however, will give you 1 point, and I will get 1, 2, 3, 4 from my sheds. My Cathedral of Katarina only gives me 2 points, and she has the ability that says empty squares in your town are worth 0 instead of -1. So I will get 2 points for being able to build out my cathedral, and all of my empty spaces, meaning this and this, which normally would be -2, are actually worth 0. So adding all that up, 2, 4, 7, 11, 13 plus 1 is 23 points. That's not very good, especially considering that I've scored 33 points. So not bad, not great, but not bad, but total of 23 points. How did that do with you, and how did it compare to your score? Did you beat me, or did I beat you? So that's Tiny Towns. Did you win? Did I win? I don't know. Leave a comment below. Let us know in the YouTube channel if I beat you or you beat me. Again, my score was 23. Truth be told, that's not my best. My best is about 33 or 34. I've played a lot of games of Tiny Towns. I've played about 12 now, actually, which is pretty fun. And then this game was a little longer than normal because we were taking some time for everyone to be able to place their resources on their buildings as you watched along. But I have been able to play Tiny Towns in about 15, 20 minutes, which is really, really cool because there's so much strategy and so much depth, and being able to re-swizzle and change buildings and play again is really, really fun. It's a great little game. I'd like to thank Alderac Entertainment Group for providing us a copy of the game to be able to make this video for you. And again, whether this is right around the launch time or 5 or 10 years later, this video is still relevant for you to go through and play and let us know. Really looking forward to that. Feel free to leave a comment below in the YouTube channel. You can, of course, chime in on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram by searching Crits Happen. Leave a picture of your town and let us know what your score was. We'd love to hear how it worked out. We'd love to hear what monuments you used and if you were able to build them and construct them and how they helped you to probably beat me, because 23 may not be the greatest of scores in the grand scheme of the internet playing against you. So we'll see how it works out. Until we see you next time, though, feel free to like and share this video. Of course, you can subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications for more information. But I want to say thank you very much for joining us on this little journey, and I hope that you had a lot of fun. Until we see you next time, keep rolling those dice, and we hope they're all crits.